wasn't until the 1860s that racing as we know it today began to appear. Born in 1863, the Barb.
The fearsome black demon, as he was later to be known, was a striking jet black colt, well proportioned, with muscular quarters, impressive shoulders, and the soundest of legs. Although not tall, his explosive racing ability combined with an equally torrid temperament made him an entity of the turf. His sire, Sir Hercules, was bred near Windsor, 35 miles from Sydney, and was one of the first really great colonial bred sires in Australia. Post loomed up, Exile made a last lunge to get within a head of the colt. The Barb, fighting courageously, struggled in to win by a narrow margin, running the fastest time yet for the cup. Finishing third, three lengths from the winner, was the second favourite, Falcon. But the judge failed to accept him as official third place getter because the gelding's colours were not those listed on the official card. During his racing career, the Barb recorded many great achievements, including the weight carrying record of 67 kilos for his win in the Sydney Cup. Even though he was unsuccessful at stud, the Black Demon's performances remained unsurpassed until the arrival some 20 years later of the great Carbine. Carbine was a light bay and stood a shade over 16 hands. Deep barreled, with a powerful back, he was rather light boned and small in the forearm. A blaze began high on his forehead, and one of his most distinct features was a white stocking on the near hind leg. His sire, Musket, a handy stayer unwanted by British breeders, was farmed out to the Antipodes. In those days, Australia and New Zealand were used as a dumping ground for second-rate stock. Ironically, he proved to be a bargain and three times headed the Australian sires list. Carbine was the third foal of Mersey, an unimpressive chestnut mare bred in England whose owner thought so little of her that he didn't bother to try Mersey on the racetrack. Instead, he sold her to the Auckland Stud Company in New Zealand. So from a background of unfashionable, unwanted parentage came a horse that was then, and now, regarded as one of the most influential sires in the world. After a string of impressive early wins in New Zealand, his owner Dan O'Brien set the colt named Carbine for the Rich Victoria Derby in Melbourne. The late 80s was a boom period for racing. Prize money grew substantially and the average attendance was far greater than it is today. It was in this atmosphere the colt from across the Tasman made his auspicious debut. Even though he hadn't raced for over 7 months, Carbine started a heavily back favourite at 7-4. He looked to have the derby well within his grasp when jockey Bob Derrett suddenly dropped his hands, not seeing until too late the Australian gelding Ensign, who was able to get up in the last stride and win by a head. After redeeming himself with two victories during the carnival, O'Brien elected to cash in on the good impression the colt had made and placed Carbine under the auctioneer's hammer. The campaign was planned by Higginbottom, in which Carbine was successful in 7 of his 10 starts, including the Sydney Cup. Trainer Higginbottom knew he had the best horse in Australasia and carefully planned the four-year-old's campaign, culminating in the Melbourne Cup. But that cup was to elude him, as Carbine split a heel during training, restricting his performances, an injury that was to plague him throughout his career. When Carbine returned to the racetracks in 1890, the champion was at his awesome best, virtually unbeatable. Bookmakers refused to take bets on the horse, offering odds of 5-1 bar one in any race Carbine contested. In the remaining 20 starts of his career, Carbine only tasted defeat twice, setting an amazing sequence of 15 consecutive wins. The highlight of his racing career came when owner Donald S. Wallace set Old Jack, as Carbine was now affectionately known, for the 1890 Melbourne Cup. And what a cup it was. Never had a horse carried almost 10.5 stone over the grueling 2 miles. The prize money was a record £10,230 and a record number of 39 starters lined up. Old Jack entered the enclosure to an enthusiastic reception from a crowd of 85,000 people. For almost a minute, Carbine was again up to his old tricks, refusing to move away from the applause until his trainer, prepared for such an event, urged him along. In race record time, under a weight which still stands as a record, Carbine, the 4-1 favourite, won that cup by 2.5 lengths from the soon-to-be Sydney Cup winner Highborn, who was in receipt of a staggering £50 from the champion. From 43 races, Carbine had 33 wins and was unplaced only once. He won over varying distances, carrying massive weights under all sorts of conditions, often plagued by that recurring heel injury. But it was as a stallion, he was to leave an indelible mark.